Hello, sustainable growers. This is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. Today, I want to talk about a very interesting fish to have in aquaponics. A lot of people are talking about it from a cleaning point of view because it's supposed to be a good cleaner. This is the catfish. Before starting the video, don't forget that you can obviously subscribe to the channel. You can get a free guide to build your own aquaponic setup from the description of the video. Catfish are very interesting fish because they live on the bottom of the tank most of the time, but they are always looking for some food. As soon as you put some food into your aquaponic setup, they're going to look everywhere. And they got some very interesting organs that are sensory organs, two very long, you can call it moustache, and they are always feeling what is in the tank. So as soon as you put food in the tank, they can feel it, and they're going to look around trying to find it. And obviously, this fish is mostly designed to eat the food on the bottom of the tank. So if you got all the fish and you put a few catfish into the tank, if you overfeed the fish after a while, you know, when the food is on the bottom and is waiting on the bottom, most of the fish lose interest, while the catfish, because it's designed to eat the food from the bottom of the tank, it's gonna still eat this food. So obviously once the catfish is full, it's full, right? But it's gonna continue to eat while the other fish are gonna stop, right? The other fish, even if they are not completely full, if the fish food has been sitting on the bottom for a while, they are gonna stop and they're gonna wait for new food to come, while the catfish may continue to eat this food. So that's very interesting because it's gonna avoid to waste some fish food. I know a lot of aquaponics keepers are gonna think it's not wasted because it's still into the aquaponic setup. So obviously, even if the fish are not eating it, at one point it's gonna break down and it's gonna finish into the water pump, and therefore it's gonna go into the vegetable side. And that's correct. The nitrogen are not lost. But the thing is, this fish food could have been used by the fish first, while if no fish eat it, it goes directly to the vegetables, so you don't grow any fish protein. So it's much better if part of this fish food is used to grow actual fish, because the fish food is quite expensive in aquaponics. So if you have one, two or more catfish into your aquaponic setup, we're gonna improve what we call the conversion ratio of the quantity of fish food by quantity of fish produced. So I think it's a really good fish to have in your aquaponic setup. So that's the first thing, right? It's not really cleaning the tank by itself, right? But it's eating the dead food a bit more than the other fish. The other thing is that it's a very social fish. So as I was just saying, you can have just one or two into your tank and they're gonna mix really well with the other fish. They're gonna, they are very friendly, very social. Except if you have a very, very big catfish, you know, because they can grow to very big sizes depending on the species. You know, there are hundreds of species of catfish on Earth. Most of them are quite social. But if you put the big ones in Europe, we call them silure. Silure can be like, you can reach almost 3 meters. So if you put one of these fish in aquaponics with a goldfish, the goldfish is gonna disappear straight away, right? They can, some of them can even eat some chicken, or we heard about some dogs attack. So you know, a huge catfish, a huge silure, is not to put in an aquaponic setup with other fish. But if you respect the size, you know, if you have a small catfish or fish of the same or the similar size, you can definitely mix them with other species. So that's a very interesting thing. And the third thing is obviously the behavior of this fish. The behavior is very unusual, very different to the other fish, a bit less active. It's still active, but in a very different way. So it, you know, if you are interested by the aquatic life, and if you like to look at your setup, I think it's good to have those kind of things into the aquaponic setup that are gonna add a bit of, how to say, biodiversity into the fish tank. And you know, it's always good to see those different behavior. It's the same thing as having some crayfish or yabbies into your aquaponics setup. You know, it's not that you're going to produce a lot of them, it's not that you're going to eat a feast from them, but at least it adds a bit of life into the setup and a bit of biodiversity. So that's some little things that I recommend to have into your aquaponics, setup, because simply it adds a bit of life in the setup, and everyone can come around and see the different species of fish. Oh, have you seen this one? Have you seen that one? It's same as having an aquarium at home. You like to have different species. You don't want to have only one species of fish, depending on what you like. But most of people like to see a bit of everything, so it creates more animation into the tank. Finally, I would like to add the fact that if we say that it's a bottom feeder, don't forget that catfish, when they are hungry, they just come on the surface as soon as you put the fish food into the water. So if you got a big catfish, he's gonna eat a lot before all the other fish, if he's bigger than the other fish around. He's gonna eat everything, and obviously once the fish is full, it's just gonna go into a pipe or wherever, he's just gonna sit on the bottom. And then if you put too much fish food is gonna stay on the bottom of the tank and it's gonna stay there. The catfish is gonna be full. It's gonna take a while for the catfish to start to digest until it can start to be attracted by the food again. Another interesting fact about catfish is that they got some spines in the fins. So, you know, they got three spines around the body. And therefore, they don't have many predators, because the predators are not able to eat them because of those kind of pikes. So I'm gonna try to show you those kind of pikes on the fish. They are very sharp, and if you got some catfish at home, if you manipulate them, please be very careful, because it can very easily damage your skin, make a hole, and it's then very painful. So when you touch a fish, always put your hands into the water first. Then if the fish has got some scales, the scales are not going to stick to your hand. Catfish doesn't have any scales, they got only a very smooth skin. But for any other fish, always put your hands into the water. Catfish can stay a while out of the water. And here is, I can feel his spines. So you see the fins, these fins here, and the dorsal one as well. So the three fins that are just around the head, they look soft, but actually inside there is a spike, and it's very, very hard. So if you're a predator and you touch it, it's gonna penetrate inside your hands, inside your skin. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget that you can subscribe to the channel. Give me a like if you enjoyed it. You can share it with your friends. And don't forget that if you haven't started aquaponics yet, you can get a free guide from the description of the video to begin your aquaponics setup straight away. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!